delegates. SFS, this is a general manager, IT Chiefs Limited. I'll brief you first about the Gujarat Mineral Development Corporation. Started in the 1963 to tap the mineral activities in the state of Gujarat, promoted by government of Gujarat. The present turnover of the company is around 1600 crores and net profit is coming around 500 crores. The major business is lignite, which is used in the power generation, and 80% of the turnover is coming from the lignite itself. We are also in the power generation also, where we use the raw material as lignite itself, and we are also in the renewable energy also, that is wind energy as well as solar energy also. So what we are using is that whatever that mines are there, then it is resurfaced as it is, after that utilizing the same space for the solar energy. That's what has been used in one of the sites, Panagro, which is in the Kutch district. Company is considered as one of the Navratna in Gujarat, and throughout the inception of the company to this latest, so far it has made the progress and profit only. There is no loss so far in the company. Technology to be adopted into the mining sector is really important, in the sense that if you consider the other industries, the mining sector industry is not that technology savvy so far compared to the other manufacturing industry or financial industries in different cities. Considering certain limitations about the skill set, infrastructure and other things. So question is that why information technology is required into the mining sector? See, for mining sector, overall the lead time to make the mine operational is around 3 years at least. And the machineries, the earth treatments which are utilized over there are so costly over there. So if you make the lead time higher and higher, or even production point of view also, if you don't synchronize everything, then your cost is increasing and it doesn't become viable as far as the market is concerned. Information technology can help here to the mining industry, whereby you can do the planning, production, mining itself, mine planning basically, and production scheduling and planning, as well as other processes for dispatches and ore processes and everything, which if you synchronize everything, then you can utilize the productivity properly, efficiently, as well as the earth equipments, which are so costly, are always available to you considering the maintenance and other factors. Application of information technologies are like starting with the exploring the data, basically for mapping and analyzing the resource, basically what is available on that. And then once you decide that this much reserve is available, then you have to go with the design that particular mine, that how much production that it will give, and in which how much in the life of that particular mine to do that. And that approvals point of view, you have a fixed production per year for that mines. So that production planning also is required, and then maintenance of that equipment, of that heavy earth equipments, which are very important one, and that availability also is important as far as production is concerned. Other core applications which are normally in all the industries like procurement, then HR, finance, sales, order placement, those kind of common core applications are always there, no doubt. The sales application or order management is different than the normal industry. I have covered mining scenario also, that it takes the high capital investment and everything. At GMDC, we have a 15 mining centers which are quite operative with almost exactly 5 mines are with the lignite, 8 mines are with the bauxite manufacturing, 1 mines is basically manganese ore, and 1 is for the metal smelter. See, mining locations are at the very, very remote places, and connectivity, communication, as well as integrating all these functions, which I said like core functions as well as the mining operations, scheduling, planning, everything. Synchronizing all this will give you the overall efficiency of the mining operations. So integrating all these business functions was the first requirement, because otherwise normally it goes in silos compared to the mines-to-mines point of view. Customer services point of view, earlier days at GMDC, customer has to come basically at the site itself, that is corporate building at head office, which we tried later on to outsource with the banks, Axis Bank specifically, within the Gujarat, so that they can take the delivery order from the any bank branch by paying the money, advance money. But that was also again limitation, no? That within the bank hours only that was available. By implementing ERP, there is a customer portal itself is available where customer can make the order straight away from the website, so from their desk itself, and they can make the payment to the net banking online. So immediately order is released to them, that is available on their desk. And system generates the mail which is forwarded to the customer. In turn, it is transferred to the transporter for onward processing center. Standardization of processes also was one of the issues, because certain process, not all the process, but 5 to 10% processes becomes customized in the sense that it is available site to site may differ also. So that was also another process that has been considered over here. Transparency, it has been brought very well through this ERP implementation. The reason being that the workflow which is available with this, and document management and content management kind of thing, whereby any processes where approval is required, no? Thus all processes through workflow, it is passing through the all the responsibility which is available, approval authorities which is available, and the data is centrally repository which is available, whereby whoever that authority or responsibility is available, they can go through the transactions which are occurring at any point of site, maybe in Kutch, maybe in Bhavnagar site, or maybe in Surat site kind of thing. So any point of time management has having the transactions details, no? Production details, that how much production is going with the lignite, how much production is going with the bauxite kind of thing, immediately at any point of time, real time information is available. Our 5 mines are running 24/7, 365 days, and almost 800 to 1000 trucks are released every day. Connectivity was the another issue. I think that is with all mining companies will are facing this, because mining sites are at the remote locations basically, where infrastructure is definitely an issue. And we were also facing this kind of issue. My farthest site is the Parendur, which is 550 kilometers away from the head office. And by this connectivity, I'm getting latency of around say 50 milliseconds this time, now onwards. So that is what the connectivity has been established. And any user or any stakeholders can do the activity from any location with the central repository available at the head office, and they are communicating straight away. They are utilizing this software like that, they are operating from the head office. That was speed and access available. Centralized architecture, as I said, and proper MIS, and those kind of is a byproduct of the ERP, and that has been developed. Most important is the alert which is available. alerts which are available, like for maintenance point of view, if you talk about the meter based or say hours based, then if you define that it is a 250 hours are over, then maintenance is required. So before say 230 hours are over, then system realizes that next few days 20 hours are available. So the system gives the alert to the concerned department that the maintenance is due for this particular thing. So that way the system, the equipment's availability and everything was very high. To implement this ERP system, along with synchronizing with a lot of like communication, networking and so many things, the challenges were also very high considering the mining sector. As I said, standardization of process and codification across the organization for centralized codes or item codes and those kind of things. If it is not centralized, communicated kind of thing, probably that code may differ site to site kind of thing. So that standardization was there. Migration of data was another challenge in the short span of time which we have to finish it. Change management is always an issue with every company, that whenever you make this kind of major change, you have to keep all the people together, right from low level, that is transaction taking place, to management top level, that is steering committee kind of thing, or top level authority management kind of thing. So what we did is that right from the inception of the project, you know, a lot of activities carried out, like workshops carried out, internal magazines were there, lot of meetings were handled, actual visits to the sites and talking to the users about their issues and everything, about the progress of the ERP, those kind of thing. And change management has helped a lot while the actual implementation started. Next is mindset of stakeholders in accepting change process and technology. Similarly, skill set which is available with the mining sector, that is again one of the major challenge, where you want them to use the technology at the remote place. Training to the employees in the limited time period, that was important because 1 month or 1.5 month maximum is available for the ERP implementation. And to train almost 2,000 people at a time is definitely a task. And for that, what we have used is that video conferencing system using office communication server, where a normal webcam you can utilize as a video conferencing. And training were given on that desk also, except the core group users who were trained at the head office parallelly. Operational difficulties in starting activities with big bang approach. There was no rollout. At a stretch, all the 15 mines and corporate office, all the applications, all 12 to 15 applications were straight away computerized. With the day itself, all legacy systems were stopped. And being a listed company, the challenge was that we have to produce the results successfully and deliver it to them. Critical success factors, which is I've already covered. These are the different applications which have been covered, like HR, mines management, which is considering all this mine securing and management, production securing, everything. Sales and dispatch, quality management, plant management, production management, materials management, finance management, environment, health, safety, document management, project management, PDF and payroll, and central repository for the MIS mandatory data warehouse management kind of. Along with the ERP, what we have covered is data center, servers, computers, hardware, totally replaced human and human connectivity, which was important, and TLS email connectivity, this 50 millisecond latency has been established. Corporate email solution which was given. Help desk has been implemented in unified communication system for video conferencing and other things. ERP lifecycle and project implementation methodology is a standard one. What is important is that the three stakeholders which are there, the customers, employees and the vendors. For them, the technology is given right from like customer's point of view. Right, registration itself is through the portal. Thereafter, order placing also through the portal, completely online. Then the customer does not have to come to the office at all. Then order placing is there, then dispatch is taking place, which is completely automated. And whenever the truck is dispatched, a message, SMS, that is going to the customer when your truck has been dispatched. At the one hand, the customer statement has been made to them through the system automatically, and whatever that refund which is to be given to the customer also has been automated system through the NEFT RTGS, and whatever that complaints or anything that is through the website has been handled through the system. So customer does not have to walk in except he wants to. But otherwise all the operations can be carried out through the system itself, through the technology itself. For employees' point of view, they don't have to ask anything to the concerned department, because right from biometric attendance system, from where they are putting their attendance, which is linked with the bureau also, and incentive point of view also, in the ERP system. And then normally other employee self-services like leave, then claims for tools and other things, everything has been completely on the ERP, so they don't have to come to the head office or to ask to certain people for that. And for vendors' point of view, all the inquiries, everything, e-procurement, e-tendering, which is going on, and their payment and everything also is through NEFT RTGS. So that is completely automated kind of thing. This is what has, once we have implemented the ERP, a lot of technology has been implemented like this, and it has made a lot of change into the organization this way. Thank you.